everyone. It is Friday the 18th of February. The time is 1:04 p.m. And the temperature outside is 31 degrees. And we are at the Bras Basah MRT station. This is the water element on top next to the SMU. So we're looking at it from below. And then that's the escalators leading down to MRT. And I just stopped by at the 7-Eleven to get something to drink after a previous walk. And here we go again. We're going back to Bras Basah. The plan is to follow the road to Raffles Hotel and just do a quick exploration of their sort of a courtyard and garden. And that might be it. We'll see. But at first, let's get to a street level. Kind of nice to come here for the aircon as well, but we'll get back to street level. And it's a really lovely day, a little bit overcast with a bit of blue skies as well, and getting warmer as we speak. So I think it might stick to 31 though, but with the sun out it always feels a little bit warmer. And we're right next to Queen Street here. So we're kind of coming out at Queen Street. So pretty much right where I left the previous walk. That would be a view down Queen Street. We'll go to Bras Basah. Actually, let's go the other way so we don't have to cross for the second time. Seems like the smart thing to do. Simply live by a tin box. I thought tidy box. That's on my left here. Living in a tiny box is what many of us in the city do, but don't know if I'd advertise it. They have a stormtrooper mask there. And it was tin box, not tiny box. So here we are on Bras Basah Road. Just past the Singapore Management University, sort of that really beautiful green area there in the middle. But this building, still part of it. We're coming to Victoria Street. Chimes, the restaurant and bar area is on the other side, on my right. Oh, they're having an open house for Singapore Management University. We have some nice city views at the background there. I have no idea what the way still. I don't need a green light or not, but it seems like it. Yep, not a green light anymore though. Used to be one once upon a time. But the bus really just kind of parked so that there was no way of seeing. Not cool bus. Don't do that. So that's Chang's on the other side. But I visited inside Chang's on one of the earlier videos not too long ago, since returning to Singapore. And I don't think things have drastically changed. System. And just ahead of us is now Raffles Hotel. I walked through there a couple of times, not on video, but they have a really nice, well, the building is nice. Now it's been renovated as well. But they have a really nice garden space. There in the corner, you just might be able to make out the sign for Long Bar, which is the bar that takes credit for Singapore Sling. It's not a cheap place to get one, but I think kind of a fun thing to do if you're a tourist. Certainly one that all the tourist guides will mention. It's on the upper floor, the second floor. And Raffles Hotel, of course, has a long history in Singapore. I think we're going to see something about it on these signs here. I think they have photographs. So they're opening, the Long Bar is opening at 3. So I don't think we can see it today. It's only 1:10. So pictures from 1921, 1913, the 1950s. They make a sort of big deal of creating that kind of atmosphere in the bar as well. So Raffles opened in 1887. We'll have a look at where Long Bar is. That's what you get for Singapore Sling, and they also kind of make it in a way that it's a little bit entertaining, I guess. It's not a bad place to visit. You do need to have a budget of your own. I think $25 a drink. So the windows here won't let me sort of get a peek, but this would be where it is. Here's a look at this sort of inside space here. I think we'll go and walk through the garden. They also have a lot of different shops around here. Maybe not your cheapest ones. Oh, not bad, 10 Singapore Slings. That's a challenge for someone. That will set you back considerably at Raffles. But it does have a really, really nice feel inside here. So you could get whiskey here. It's really, really beautifully done. it's a very peaceful place to go for a walk as well. It's got these lovely spaces. We can explore through here. No, there. I will just walk back quickly. Looking at the garden here. The room here will set you back also more than $1,000 a night. So just something to keep in mind if you're dreaming about it. There's a cafe here, which I think is quite nice inside. It's open. They have a lunch special for $25, so something like that would be more affordable than spending a night here. You've got your little shops for high-end watches. Sort of thing. And then the space there in the middle where you could get drinks. You do have escalators as well. You don't want to walk up the stairs. Another outside space used by the restaurants and bars around here. And lobsters. With any possible info.
Papa, for yummy.
I remember the train with that name from London. It's the same one though. Good city views all around. And we come back to more normal life, I think. This is not Bridge Road. I think I want to end up back closer to where we started. there are other nice areas inside Raffles. Other sort of garden-like spaces as well. But they're fairly similar. They do have a really, really nice feel. And I've never had a problem sort of just going in to see them or, you know, just have a look. It's sometimes really nice to go to a place that's sort of away from the city streets, and it is really quiet in here. Quiet and beautiful. I mean, look at that. It's like a park. The kind of remarkable thing is that they've been here for quite a while, and then the city just kind of appeared around. And even though it is expensive for sure, it's kind of nice to have some of those things. Still around. I mean, it's some of these things surely are ridiculously priced for the most of us, but we can enjoy it still. Have a look. And maybe just roll our eyes a little bit, maybe, depending on what club you belong to. Sometimes you see really nice cars parked in front here as well. Makes sense. But yeah, maybe have a look and then head for some more affordable drinks at times or. There are a lot of places around here, which will be really nice to visit. There we go. Here's Raffles City. And I think I will continue on Bras Basah Road. Let's see my words there. But I think that was kind of the main part of the walk, so thank you for joining me from Bras Basah MRT station. Following Bras Basah here, and then a little bit of a tour inside the Raffles Hotel, just like we would tour any park or any historical site, really. I'm not suggesting you come here other than to maybe enjoy the garden. But it is fun to see it. And of course, if you do want to, all the hotels in Singapore, I'm sure, will welcome you with that price. Most of them, anyway. not a cheap one. I hope you enjoyed that big insight, and if you'd like to see more videos from Singapore, mostly walking the streets, then I'm sure you will know that you can subscribe to the channel, and if you do, that will be much appreciated. And with that, peace of the city. I'm Marina Bay Sands there at the back. I hope I'll see you again soon.